when the preparation for Dori cassava pudding, you will be needing 2 pounds of cassava, condensed milk, 1 tin condensed milk, 1 tin carnation milk, 1 pound brown sugar, a piece of ginger, nutmeg, coconut milk, 1 coconut. You get the first milk from the coconut, and that's what you're going to use. Vanilla, 1 teaspoon of vanilla, and butter, 1 butter would be 4 tablespoons of butter. The cassava, you need to peel the cassava. After you finish peeling the cassava, this is how it's supposed to stay. After you have the cassava this way, you need to grate the cassava. So when you grate the cassava, you want it to have a soft texture, just like if you're doing the coconut, but this will be much more softer. Cassava, this is the texture we get when it is grated already. Now we want to add the ingredients. Butter, nutmeg, nothing much. If you put too much nutmeg, it tastes a little bit bitter, right? So half a nutmeg, ginger, vanilla, condensed milk already. We don't want to add too much sugar, so we want to use sugar. Then you add the coconut milk. So you add all the ingredients at once and you just stir. Some people melt the butter, but they rather you take out the butter earlier and you set it aside so it melts on its own, no? You can taste it, your perfection, and if you want to add anything more, sugar, condensed milk, you can do so, alright? And this is how it's supposed to be, right? So that you have finished already, stir and put all the ingredients together. We can use an iron pot. You can use this direct on the fire on low heat. Or you can use a cake pan and you can bake it in your stove for 1 hour and 15 minutes on the fire hot. Now we're going to use only the coal to put on top, and then we're going to cover it up. We're going to cook it first and cover it, okay? So let me put this in the pot one time. This is the way that how they taught us to do it. This is the way how the Garifuna people does it. We don't do anything on stove back in the days because stove didn't exist. You stir, you continue to stir till you feel that the bottom is cooking already, and from there you just leave it on low heat, so no high fire. So it's basically you're going to cook it in low and cold. And then you're going to cover it. And then we're going to put some fire coal over it so the top could have that pretty crisp brown. As you can see, it's a little bit of fire, it's underneath it, so the cassava pudding can cook. After 1 hour and 15 minutes, this is the final result of the cassava pudding.